Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Hope you're doing well. I know it's just been such a fantastic week so far. I'm really, really loving this. I'm loving the fact that I'm getting back to my morning walks again, doing my videos, talking to you guys, and I started back exercising yesterday morning. Yes, I am a little sore, but not that bad. I'm sure by tomorrow morning, my muscles will be screaming at me, but it's okay because I'm going to be exercising again tomorrow. So yeah, basically just the 3 days a week for right now. At some point, I would like to increase that to full 6 days. So yeah, ambitious. I know. I know. I love being a card. What can I say? So anyway, yeah. Ride sharing has been quite interesting here lately too. Yeah. I think there's something in the air with, at least with millennials. Not anything against millennials or anything, but it just seems to be something reoccurring, mostly females, basically female millennials. It's like, pace yourselves, ladies. It's like, yeah, stay away from the stuff. If you know what I mean by that. Drinking, okay, fine, but you know, any other stuff, yeah, pace yourselves. More like stay away from it, period. And as far as drinking, pace yourselves. It's like there's a reason why you're acting the way that you're acting, why you're having so-called, quote-unquote, panic attacks and so forth, okay? So hopefully, if I have any lady millennials who are watching this, yeah. I've had some real funny stories that have happened here recently. One of them was last night, so. But anyway, as far as taking care of yourselves, you know, of course it's okay to go out and have fun and so forth. We all have to cut loose every once in a while. It's one of the reasons why I like doing the ride sharing, because it's my time, actually, to be able to cut loose and have some fun, you know, because I do love the energy of this city. Even though I don't partake in any of it, it's never been my thing, but I do like the energy. So yeah, it's very youthful, and yeah, in some ways it can be intoxicating. And so yeah, it's always a good idea to cut loose, have fun, but at the same point, pace yourselves. So, excuse me. Also, here recently, I had a wonderful opportunity. I've been trying to cook and bake more at home. I had gotten into a little bit of a pattern of eating out and eating prepared desserts, even though they might be gluten-free and so forth. I still prefer to try and do things myself at home. So, and of course a lot of it is, actually it all is, because of my gut issues that I have. So, on that note, here recently I had decided to go eggless. I had done a lot of research on doing, you know, on egg substitutions and so forth. Also looked at items that were pre-done for you. All you do is add water and so forth. But ultimately, I decided, because I wasn't really finding a whole lot. Actually, I only found one product out there that at least all the ingredients were conducive to what I would need and everything. Unfortunately, a lot of them use ingredients that have negative reactions on me. But unfortunately, even with that one product, I still wasn't satisfied with it. So I found a blog, actually. I don't remember the name of it. If you want it, let me know, and I'll see about sending it to you. Basically, she's been vegan for 20 years because of autoimmune disorders. And she had a great article on doing egg substitutions with ingredients that you probably already have in your own house. And I did. I tried it with some cookies, and I went completely gluten-free. Well, I had been doing completely gluten-free, but I had been using a mixed flour. And I was just like, no, I don't want to go down that road. And I made some cookies this past weekend. They worked out great. So I have a little bit of tweaking to do or what have you. But, you know, I still wouldn't mind at least sharing that information with you all also. So hope you all are having a great Tuesday. I love you all. And I'll talk to you soon.